1980, when I got my bronze, it was a bit of a hard road for girls at first, because initially they, even though surf wanted girls, women to be in surf lifesaving and do their patrols and everything, we weren't always supported when it came to competition.
I don't know, it's a more male dominant sport. None of the boys can catch up.
Oh, I see a wave for you. I see.
Women's final. Here we go. It's a swim leg, then a board leg.
So there are pathways for young women in any area of surf. You might want to compete, you might want to train, you might want to be an educator.
So we definitely have like a sister connection, like a family connection with like the people that we train with at Surf Club.
Hi, I'm Femke. I'm in under 17s at Surf Club. And I'm 15 years old.
I'm Macy and I'm 10 years old. I'm Millie and I'm 12 years old.
My name's Jenny Taylor. I've been involved in surf life saving actively for the last 40 years, but was a social member before that, because in 1980 was the first time ladies were allowed to do their bronze. My background was in surfing. My family were all real keen surfers. I lived in Melbourne and we went to Torquay every weekend and we all just surfed. And from the age of probably about 5 or 6, I was in the surf.
I think I started in under 9 and then maybe to under 11s now.
I started in under 8s, I think, which was at the time the earliest you could start.
It's been 40 years since we've been active patrolling members. When we first started, there was probably 10% of the membership might have been female, and probably only 5% of that might have been, you know, actively on patrols. Now in Australia, I think we're about 45% of the membership is female.
Like, the trip definitely was like the best bit, like driving up there and like, you really like the excitement like starts building.
We went couch surfing for fun.
We went couch surfing
on a block couch. It was very good.
Yeah. But then we'll always be stopping, going fast and slow, and action, reaction, sticks and stones and broken bones. Those for peace and those for war.
What are we doing?
In the mangroves, that was, the parents were really excited about that.
Yeah, they were all going to get eaten by crocodiles. We stayed there for 2 weeks?
Yeah,
2 weeks, yeah.
We just became closer from that trip. And yeah, it was good to get to know everyone better. Like, before Broome, like, we all like knew each other, but we weren't like necessarily like as close.
My race tactic is don't go fast at the start, because then you won't be able to like finish the race. So just go slow, so you, well, not slow, but just keep your stamina, so I can like finish the race.
I would like to see females aspire to any leadership roles that they want to undertake.
I think it's about getting to know the environment around you and knowing how to deal with any type of swell, especially at trig, and training to save people's lives, basically.
Yeah, so I hope the young people, like, look at, or the younger age groups, like, look at our group and me like that, like, you know, like, oh, I want to be like that when I'm in youth and things like that.
Like Femke and like you and my sister's age group in youth now, like, definitely them.
Surf life saving is just an amazing family to be part of, and I look at my surf life saving community as my family.
Definitely go and just give it a go.
Yeah, give it a bash.
There's just like little moments that you have like during training competitions, like when you catch that perfect wave.
The amount you put into it is what you get out of it, so give it a go.